What's up, guys? This is Htaed7 from RCT. Yes, I am back. Gotta say, from the outset, sorry this is kind of thrown together really quick, but I wanted to address a couple of things. First off, thanks for all those people out there who have been waiting. I know I've been in an extended hiatus basically for more than a few months. Gonna give you a little update on that as well. I'm sorry guys that I actually missed the Switch launch. Right now it's I'm kind of struggling here to make this video because I'm sick, so I'm trying not to either cough a lot or kind of mess things up, but I'm gonna go slowly and pace myself so I can actually do this. Now, in terms of the streams, I know a lot of you guys are out there asking, when am I going to come back? When am I going to start doing the shoot 'em ups? All of that is coming. I just want to cut this out first. Everything is, I'm already all set. I have all my gear. Capture card is here. The Switch, obviously, is here. My computer is here. Everything is here. The mic, everything. Perfect. So the setup is complete. And I'm actually now going to be doing these streams with a 4K monitor that I have, and I'll be adding probably later on some 4K gaming as well. Now, in terms of the update, well, basically it goes as follows. As you guys know, I move over here back to the States. I was dying for like the longest to come back, and I came back. After the Seattle's stint, I came to Pennsylvania, started working here, and it's been nonstop since. I haven't been able to stream. I started doing some things, some streams, some videos and stuff, but I couldn't really handle it with the work, because the job that I'm at right now is very, very physically demanding. And of course, when you add to the fact that most of the time I'm 6 and 7 days in, so I have barely any time off. The little time off that I have, I do a little bit of gaming, and most of it is sleeping and doing, you know, stuff here in the apartment and stuff. But it's been a kind of a long, grueling but fulfilling thing all the same, because I have been progressing little by little. And long-term goals, RCT ain't going anywhere. On the contrary, I mean, as long as there's an audience and there's people out there who enjoy this, I'll keep doing it. There's even something in the works with Afro Soul. I know you guys remember her. We used to do the tag teams on the some of the games, multiplayer games. There's plans of her making the move as well, so fingers crossed. I'll keep you guys up to date with that. But okay, enough of that. You guys know I'm here, not going anywhere. Been just busy, tired as hell, working very hard, trying to get things in order. And now let's go to the NX or the Switch. Now, the road to the Switch has been very long and hard, and that's what she said. Basically, yeah, Aaron, I know you're laughing with that one. I did it for you. Basically, Aaron and I, with the Relic Outlaws stuff, which more of that is coming up soon, you guys are gonna see. The trip that we had at Fun Spot, you know how that went. That was crazy fun, and have some things that are being planned. Nothing set in stone yet, but when it comes to the Nintendo Switch as we now know it, before, when it was in development, I mean, first, to give you a little bit of context here, I've been following every single Nintendo console from the Wii on, the development cycle of it. I'm a fan of, at least in the development of the Wii forward, going forward, forums like Reddit, NeoGAF, a whole bunch of other channels where you can get info and have people in the know talk about it, and rumor, and I've been following that, and it became, at a point, it became as addictive as gaming itself. Now, to give you a little bit of context here, and why this, to me, was, I think, is the most important launch for Nintendo since, I don't know, probably the Super Nintendo, in terms of, you know, going big, you know. And it's because with the Wii development, there was a lot of hype, yes. There was a lot of mystery behind it. Nintendo was very sealed, as usual, in terms of info, not letting anything leak. And when it came time to unveil the console, the first thing that they showed off that was a mystery was the controller. Now, nobody at that time knew that it was going to be underpowered, as we later found out, and that it wasn't going to be HD, but the controller took center stage. Everything else is history. I mean, the controller was innovative. It took the world by storm. It hooked a whole bunch of casual people in, which I have a very, with that term, just like hardcore gamers. Casual to me is all the CODs and the Maddens and all that stuff that people who are not necessarily gamers, they go in because that's the thing that's in, and they go in and buy it just because, but they have no appreciation for what a gaming has been all about and is all about. So that to me is what casual is, but I digress. The thing is, basically after that, it allowed a competition to take this system, the Wii, and basically use it against Nintendo for there on out, you know, in the way of, well, you know, Nintendo's not about power anymore, and a whole bunch of quote-unquote facts started coming out. Like, fact number one, Nintendo fans don't buy third-party games. Nintendo fans, they only like cartoon games, etc., etc. You guys know because you see it all the time on the internet. And if you haven't seen it, it's very hard to miss. You'll find it everywhere. After that, the Wii U, the development was also, as I followed it, there was a certain level of, you know, hope that this was gonna be it. This was gonna take away the bad taste of the Wii, even though it was the most successful console, surpassing Xbox 360 and PlayStation 3. But, you know, in the minds of hardcore gamers, that was a failure. So, okay, in comes the Wii U, the development cycle, and a whole bunch of people started, like, already the negativity was rampant, and I could see that even before the system launched, there were a whole bunch of people and channels declaring it dead upon arrival. You know, it was going to be another underpowered system. It wasn't going to be up to the upcoming PS4 and Xbox One, which had all the hype, all the power, yada, yada, yada. What I'm trying to get at with all of this is that basically the media and the negativity surrounding the launch, even before a launch, in between development of the system, have been building up for both consoles a lot of negativity before launching. And you can see the results afterwards. Now, when it came to the NX, remember, the Wii U was Project Cafe, and the Switch, as we now know it, was NX. There was a lot of constant and very good hype with this system. There was none of the negativity, even though there was still the people were on the fence in the end how much power the system, or lack of, there was gonna be with the system. There was still a lot of hope, much more hope than with the Wii U. And there were good rumors, you know, which was very different from the Wii U. All the rumors from the Wii U that would come out would be negative in nature. So much so that even the negativity that a lot of the outlets came out during the development did not really dent the hype that was slowly building for the system. Now, there were two camps. the camp that was saying that the console, it was going to be a console, a strong console, and the hybrid camp. I myself personally got to say that I felt that I wasn't going to lose regardless whether it was going to be the hybrid or the console, because I was ready to embrace any one of them. All I wanted was a successful Nintendo console, because we need Nintendo in this industry. Remember, guys, I'm a PC gamer. I'm a multi-platform gamer. However, in this generation, I did not feel the urge, even though I can. I have the means now to do it. I could easily get an Xbox One or a PlayStation 4, a PlayStation Pro. It does not appeal to me. I have a monster PC, which I'm going to be upgrading soon. And what I need is Nintendo exclusives. Now, later down the line, I'm not going to say, because I'm not going to miss those titles. I know there's a backlog of titles that I'm going to want to play, like Uncharted 4 and the Killzone that came out in the beginning of the PlayStation 4. I might eventually, later on, if I get a chance, I'll get a PlayStation Pro or maybe a Scorpio. Who knows? But for now, PC gaming and now the Switch, I think it's going to cover me just fine. Now, what do I think? I mean, I'm not going to give you guys a review. I already missed the unboxing. The only thing that I could do, however, since my buddy, Aaron Classic Gamer, basically covered all of the stuff that I already have, like the unboxing of the system and the Pro Controller and a whole bunch of stuff. The only thing that I have different to offer is the Legend of Zelda Special Edition. It is a beautiful, beautiful packaging. Now, I went for this one instead of going for the Master, because the Master, of course, the only difference is that it has the huge, you know, a Master Sword. But for me, it wasn't practical, even though I would love to have that sword. But right now, as of right now, the lifestyle that I'm having, the less I have, less clutter, the better. Maybe eventually later on, I'll start with the collectibles. That's why I don't buy amiibos. It's not that it's not a good thing, but I don't have enough space to be, you know, having these things. So later on, maybe. Now, I'm not going to take too long with this. I'm just going to show you the essentials of what came in here. Let's see. Right here, you have nice little collector's coin. Zelda. And you have, of course, a game. Come here. The cart is inside, of course, the system. Breath of the Wild soundtrack. Awesome. And this right here, this is an actual map of Hyrule. I cannot understate this enough. This is a really cool piece. Collector's art. Oh, I hope I don't have it upside down. There you go. Yeah. Now this thing, the feel of it, it's just like, you know, it's like cloth, it's like felt. I don't know what the hell you're supposed to call that, but it feels like a damn map. And that is cool. This is something that I'll go back to later on. And of course, the centerpiece of all the goodness of this edition is, of course, the traveler's case, which is, I'm going to show you here in a second, this puppy right here. Now you're going to tell me, look at that. That is one badass case. And you open it. And inside, you have a nice little pouch. You have here, basically this is for storing games. We can store a whole bunch of games here. This Velcro style thing, you just put them in there. And of course you have the system. Get the Velcro in place so it keeps it nice and steady. And of course, my baby, right here. Woo-hoo-hoo. Yeah, picture in picture, baby. Let me turn it on here real quick. There you go. So yeah, later on, I have here, sorry for the glare, my camera's not really that good. Got Zelda there, Shovel Knight, Fast RMX, which is awesome, and a little demo of Snipper Clips. And yeah, it is pretty awesome. What do I think about the system itself? Well, I'm going to be completely honest. I already knew what to expect. I wasn't expecting it to be super powerful. However, having a system, and this is something that I need to get out. That's why I wanted to cut this video, aside from giving you guys an update. One of the things that to me makes this system have the potential to even surpass the Wii in terms of sales is, number one, Nintendo's marketing is bar none the best I've seen from them in years. They are really on the mark with the marketing. They're pushing all channels, you know, all media, even though there's negativity that they have to balance out from other outlets and other media and people who are supposedly jaded. It's still going strong. They're making really good decisions in terms of the marketing. Number two, potential for the system. Now, me personally, you know, guys, that I love emulation. I love homebrew, even though that's something that's very anti-Nintendo, and Nintendo hates that. I'm sorry, Nintendo, but I love it. You have to, it boggles the mind. Imagine all the stuff that's going to be able to be done in this thing. This thing is portable and it connects to the TV. You know, aside from the tons of games that I'm hoping that after the fusion or the merging of development teams from the 3DS camp and the console camp, I'm thinking about all of these games that were incredible games on the DS lines of systems, like Castlevania. I mean, bringing back a 2D Castlevania HD in this system, it's gonna be crazy. Metroid, the potential for Metroid here is, oh my god. And you have everything, the controls, you have motion controls, the possibility of VR, which already Nintendo has a patent. I feel that if something incredibly, unless something incredibly wrong is done along the way, I don't see this system failing at all. I mean, there's always going to be a way to get, you know, life out of it. So I'm hoping, and I think they will. I'm hoping that they succeed. I'm hoping that this will take them back to the point where they should have been for a long time, which is right up there, you know, keeping the competition in check. We need Nintendo in the industry. We need those first party titles. They're amazing. You already saw Zelda as a launch title, even though there's tons of people saying that, you know, complaining that, oh no, that system launch lineup is, it sucks, this and that. Okay, I'll give it to you. There is very few titles, but we have Zelda. And in this time, in this age and time, it still floored everybody, even the jaded people. You know, 10-10 across the board, Metacritic 98 after 60 reviews. The game is absolutely amazing. So that'll be it. I've took enough of your time, guys. I'm already 20 minutes in, and I was just going to say a few things. Thank you, guys. Thank you for supporting me, at least through the tweets, being patient. Hopefully, you guys will still stick around for when I start streaming. Hopefully, that'll start next week. Not sure if Saturday or Sunday. Remember, guys, I work 6 to 7 days, so there's a chance that if I have to work 7 days straight, I might do a stream, maybe an hour or two on a Sunday, but I'll let you guys know. Thank you for supporting RCT and Htaed7 here, signing off. I hope you guys take care, and everybody who has the Switch, enjoy it. Just enjoy it. Don't let the naysayers say crap. Just enjoy the hell out of it. It's a new Nintendo system. It's going to be great. There are tons of games coming up. We got Japanese developers on board, so hell yeah. And to all of you guys there, Anthony, Aaron, Glowing Rice, William, I'll get back to you guys. We're going to have tons of fun with the stream, and anybody else who wants to come on board as well. So take care, guys. More Relic Outlaws later on. I'm going to get in touch with Aaron to see what we can plan. Take care, guys, and thanks a lot. Bye-bye.